Welcome all of you to my channel. First of all, I would like to thank the valuable subscribers and viewers of my channel. I have already pointed out in detailed manner about aromaticity and photochemistry in my previous videos. Now we will discuss about photochemical cleavages, that is Norrish type 1, which is otherwise called alpha cleavages in this video. So before going to this one, we must know about what is photochemical cleavages. So exactly the word cleavage. What is cleavage? So cleavage is nothing but breaking of covalent bond into the smaller molecules. So we can simply say with the definition, covalent bond breakage in a molecule leading to the formation of smaller molecules. So which is called as a cleavage. So cleavage is classified into two categories. So number one category is a homolytic cleavage. So homolytic means, homo means same or equal. Lytic means loosening. So homolytic means equal loosening. That means equally sharing the electrons. So that means breaking of this covalent bond in such a way that the fragment gets one of the shared electrons. So equally it can share the electrons, which is called as an homolytic cleavage, which is otherwise called homolysis. And in this homolytic process, you will expect to get only a free radicals. So see the example here. We have a chlorine molecule here. This covalent bond, upon breaking of this bond, which will give you a Cl radical as well as another Cl radical. So now we can able to see that these products are equally shared their pair of electrons, so that this particular reaction is simply called as homolytic bond cleavage reaction. And heterolytic cleavage. Heterolytic cleavage is nothing but, hetero means different, lytic means loosening. So if you are having during the particular cleavage type of the reaction, that is your covalent bond breaking, you are expected to get your two different products. So that product which is having the formation of ions, in such cases we can able to say that it's a heterolytic cleavage. You keep remember that homolytic cleavage will result into the free radicals, whereas heterolytic cleavage result into the ions, cations and anions. And you can more often ask that where kind of the cleavage may takes place. So heterolytic cleavages are more likely to view in a polar bonds. That's why during this polar bonds are there, so that positive negative charge can able to cleave here. In such cases, what are the things is expected means that must have a electronegative atom. So during the particular reaction, there is a electronegative atom. Difference in electronegativity is there among the atom, you can expect it to get your heterolytic type of cleavages. For example, we can able to view the tertiary butyl bromide here. See here your covalent bond or here. Upon your photochemical cleavage, this CBr bond is getting broken. So in such a way that we know that bromine here and carbon here, comparing the electronegativity, bromine is more electronegative than the carbon, so that it can take up all the electrons to this. So in such a way that this becomes a cation, so the tertiary butyl cation will be resulted and there will be formation of bromide ion. So this is a very good example for your heterolytic cleavage of CBr bond. Now we can able to view that the eminent personality who has shared his Nobel Prize in 1967 for his great achievement, which is called as a Norrish type of photochemical reactions, that is Norrish type 1, Norrish type 2 and Norrish type 3. And the person is Ronald George Rifold Norrish from University of Cambridge. So now we can able to see that I have already pointed out that the Norrish type of cleavages have three possibilities. One is Norrish type 1, which is called as an alpha cleavage, Norrish type 2, which is called as a gamma hydrogen transfer, Norrish type 3, which is a beta hydrogen transfer. And we can expect that these reactions, where it happens, it must be happened in the carbonyl compounds, that is your aldehyde and keto compounds only. Now we can able to see that what is Norrish type 1 of cleavage, which is nothing but there will be a covalent bond break. That too, simply we can say the rupture of carbon-carbon bond, which is placed alpha position to the carbonyl group. Such a kind of photochemical excitation is called Norrish type 1 cleavage, which has been published by the Norrish and his team in Nature during 1936. So we can say, able to see this, this is a general reaction that we can have a carbonyl compound here. This carbonyl compound, upon excitation, that is a light induced reaction taking place, which is responsible for your photochemical cleavage. And what Norrish pointed out, that this carbonyl compound here, this particular, both the things may be called as your alpha type of position. So this cleavage is happen either this side or this side, result into the equally shared pair of electrons, so that which is called as an radicals. So this cleavage will give you a homolytic cleavage, and such a process happens followed by removal of your CO, the carbonyl group, which is called as an decarbonylation. So this decarbonylation reaction takes place in such a way that this particular radical is shifted to the alkyl group. So previously there will be one alkyl group which contains a radical, and during the secondary process this comes to another radical. So both the radical is coming, now all the radical is coming together in such a way that it reaches the termination process, so that upon termination it will be resulted into alkane as the product. So this is of course, there is a mechanism what he has mentioned, that the photochemical cleavage takes place at carbon adjacent to the carbonyl group, that's alpha position, immediate position. So there will be a fragmentation is taking place of the carbon-carbon bond, and of course everybody knows that the carbonyl group is a chromophore, so that there will be expected your type of transition is taking place, your N to pi star transition takes place, and that too we have already pointed out, this particular type of reaction is an homolytic cleavage. So homolytic cleavage means there will be a free radical formation. Now this particular reaction is carried out in a gaseous media above 100 degree Celsius. Now we can see the same reaction. Initially we have pointed out that the primary process, immediate absorption of the light, what is taking place, which is a primary process. Now this is a secondary process. Upon absorption, what will happen for the next stage for this, which is called as a secondary process. In this secondary process, Norrish pointed out that a carbonyl group is removed, which is called as a decarbonylation. So in such a way that the carbonyl group, which is having already the free radical, the radical is transferred to the alkyl group, in such a way that both radicals is having both methyl radicals or alkyl radicals is having your, or radicals is having your radicals, those radicals are joined together in such a way that you are expected to get your alkane as the product. However, depending upon the reactant, supposing that there will be a alkene may be a product also. Now we can see some few examples in the category of NORISH type 1. We can take an example of carbonyl compound as an acetone. We can take the acetone. So the primary process is taking place now. That is light induced reaction. So our light is absorbed by this one. This carbonyl group is absorbed that light in such a way that which can be excited to get your acetyl type of radical and methyl radical. And as usual, the secondary process is responsible that already we pointed out that. That's why I'm repeatedly saying secondary process is a decarbonylation, removal of CO in such a way that this radical is shifted to the methyl group. So previously we have one methyl group, methyl radical, and now another methyl radical is formed. So during the primary process, one of the methyl radicals is already formed, and secondary process another methyl radical is formed. So once two radicals is formed, these things can join together in dimerization type of the termination, which is resulted into alkane as a product. So now this other possibilities are expected in the case of our NORISH type 1 reactions. What are the possibilities? Why these possibilities are quite often taking place? So because we are handling the free radicals. Of course, once the free radical mechanism is taking place, we are expected to have three type of the reactions. That is initiation of the radical, that means generation of the free radicals in such a way that any kind of the carbonyl group is there on these particular photochemical reactions will give you generating the radicals. Once the radical is generated, the radical is possible to transfer to different kinds of the possible groups. If suppose there will be a branched chain is here, these radicals is jumping to one to other in such a way that it can possibly get a stable position for its radical. So up to which the radicals can be transferred in such a way that that particular kinds of the radical is shifted to one to other or another to another. In this particular type of things is called as a propagation. Once the propagation reaction is going on, you will meet the stabilized or stable type of radicals. Once it is formed, these radicals can join together in such a way that you are getting your final product. That too, your termination process having two different possibilities, two types. One is it can be a dimerization process. Another type, it may be a disproportionation type of the possibility. So now we can see that the acetyl radical which can be formed here, why can't this acetyl radical can join together to get one more product? See, we have mentioned you here, the methyl radical is formed, this only join to get your product. Why can't this one? That means we are having not a single mole of your acetone you are taking. If you take some 2 or 3 moles of acetone, we are expected to have your number of 2 or 3 possibilities of this one, acetyl radical and methyl radical. So that these radicals in a particular reaction media, 2 or more possibilities are that they can join together in such a way that these acetyl radicals can join together to get your biacetyl radicals, biacetyl compound. So which is nothing but 2, 3 butane diol. Another possibility is there. See that acetyl radical, once it is there, see the in general for any kind of the reaction that what we are doing in your laboratory, we are having every reactions in a conical flask or in a beaker. So that initially what we are taking you the reactant as well as the product can possibly join for another reaction. So this possibility is expecting in this case. So that all those things are there in a single flask itself. So before getting the product, everything is there in a single flask. So that what will happen, this acetyl radical once again possibly react with your acetone. So in such a way that you can expect it to get your, see what happens now, this radical is going to transform here. That means it is on reacting, it is possibly take one of the proton present here, which can be transformed to here to get your acetaldehyde as a product. So in such a way that the acetone is just changed like this, CH2CO CH3 radicals. So what is the happens here, the abstraction of proton from acetone and transfer of the radicals to the acetone by acetyl free radical. So this is one possibility to get your another free radical. So these are the possibilities, that this particular possibility is also happens in the same flask. Now the another possibility is that why can't the methyl radical can react with your acetone? Okay, we can have this possibility solved there. So here, as usual, what I mentioned that here, the particular radical, it can abstract the proton from this particular acetone and transfer the radical to this acetone. So in such a way that this methyl radical as well as the acetyl radical doing a same job, but you are getting the product acetaldehyde here, in this case methane here. Now the possibilities, two different free radical form during this reaction. This reaction may also end up with another termination type of reaction. So this termination is also dimerization takes place. So these two radicals can join together to get you a 2,5-hexanedione as a product. So we can have the similar possibility in the case of your unsymmetrical ketones. So because initially we have pointed out with the acetone, so acetone here CH3, here CH3, in such cases that is a symmetrical way. Now in the case you have methyl group here, you have ethyl group here, so in such a way that you can expect that this is a unsymmetrical way of ketone, so which is called as an unsymmetrical ketone. The reaction is as usual and as similar, and we can have the different possibilities of your formation of the radical and getting the different products. Now upon the primary process, absorption of your light, which result in the photochemical cleavage, that is a homolysis takes place or homolytic reaction takes place, which result into the free radicals. So acetyl radical and ethyl radical is formed. So one ethyl radical is already formed. Now we have your acetyl radical upon secondary process, which is called as a decarbonylation. This decarbonylation result into transfer of this radical to the methyl group and removal of CO, in such a way that methyl radical is formed and you have your ethyl radical already in the primary process. Now this reaction is getting this termination, which is called free radical termination, can join to get your propane. So any alkane is different, we simply we can point out that alkane is a product. Now here also there is a possibilities there. So like in acetone, the formation of the acetyl radical, as usual with the acetyl radicals, both the acetyl radical can join together to get your biacetyl as a product, 2,3-butanedione as a product, as usual with your acetone in the case of your methyl ethyl ketone. Now the possibility is, second possibility, we can have the ethyl radicals. So this ethyl radical can also be joined together to get your alkane as a product, so that you have ethyl radical here, another ethyl radical here, both the ethyl radical can join together to get your butane as a product. As usual, another possibility is also expected that because you have this particular reaction, we have a termination by simply we can't say this is a dimer. So because if you supposed to say methyl, methyl group is there, it may be dimer, but in the case ethyl, ethyl is the dimerization takes place. But this possibility is there to get your propane also and butane also. Whereas if suppose this particular type of combination, it may be a disproportionation type of the reaction if suppose it is expected. In such cases, this methyl radical, ethyl radical result into the tertiary butyl radical. So in such a way that we are expected to get your lot of possibilities for that, because this is a free radical reaction. Now we can see the photolysis of 3-pentanone via Norrish type 1 alpha cleavage. We can take here 3-pentanone here. So as usual, the reaction is carried out by absorption of your light. The photochemical excitation takes place, which result into the, you have two different type of the radicals, CH3, CH2, CO radical and ethyl radicals. As usual, the secondary process, always keep remember that the secondary process will be, in the case of Norrish type 1, is a decarbonylation reaction, is a secondary process. So upon the secondary process, always you keep remember that radical is transferred to the alkyl group, which may be here methyl or ethyl or propane, butane, anything can be here, which can be transferred. So removal of CO is nothing but a secondary process. So ethyl radical is formed here. Now this here, two ethyl radicals are there, radical ethyl radical 1 and ethyl radical 2 is formed. Now this particular reaction, we can have a dimer product is also, and some cases this particular reaction is end up with a disproportionation type of the reaction. That means you may be expected to get, that's why I already pointed out that during the Norrish type 1 reaction, we cannot expect the product only alkane. Alkene is also possible. Okay. If suppose dimerization only takes place, that result into alkane only. Okay. You have butane is the product upon this particular. I have pointed out here the disproportionation type of the reaction. So here ethyl radical and ethyl radical here. In such cases, if suppose one of the, here if you take it CH3, just you can take it like CH2 1 covalent bond, and you can have your another hydrogen here. In such a way that radical may transfer here, both the radical in such a way that if combined together to get your ethane, or ethane and ethene as a product. So that this particular combination of type of reaction, which may result into the alkene as a product, as well as the formation may result into the alkane as a product. So keep remember, alkane, ethane, alkene, ethene as a product. Similarly, we can go for another type of your Norrish type 1 cleavages here. So most of the cases, the free radical formation is takes place to upon your Norrish type 1 of cleavages. The adjacent, that alpha position adjacent to carbonyl group, there will be cleavage takes place in such a way that radical is formed. This radical simply called as an diradicals. So always keep remember that in the case of our Norrish type 1 reaction, first the primary process result into the free radicals. That radical, if both the radicals present in a single compound, that may be called as a diradical formation. And the secondary process as usual with decarbonylation and followed by the free radical termination. See, simply we can point out some of these questions may be asked in a competitive examination type question. So in this case, the five member ring here, upon this photochemical cleavage, this break, the cleavage takes place into formation of here one radical may come. As usual, we know that decarbonylation is taking place in a secondary process. So in this radical is transformed to here. So after transforming this one, we can able to view that is already broken, this particular bond is already broken. Upon decarbonation, this also broken in such a way that radical here and here. So in such a way that this radical can join, this has become a four member ring. So ring contraction takes place here. So this is the product. You can have your cyclic ketone and this result into cyclic hydrocarbon. So you can keep remember such a type of question, supposing that they may ask in the examination. You are able to see that the 5 member is converted into 4 member for a Norrish type 1 of cleavages. That's why I have given you another example here, cyclopentanone, 5 member ring. Upon photochemical cleavage, you will result into the cyclic cycloalkane. So that the butanone, the process as usual, either the way it may cleave, either this side or this side it may cleave. The possibility is there, both possibilities are same only. If suppose there will be any substitutions is present there which cannot possible to cleave, in such cases which one is free, that can be cleaved. So now it is cleaved here. So in such a way that radical is formed here and here. Now decarbonization takes place in such a way that the radical transformed to here. Now both the things are joined together in such a way that four member ring is expected as a product. Now this is the summary up to which what we have discussed here. The photochemical cleavage proceeds via two type of the cleavages is expected. One may be a homolytic cleavage, other may be a heterolytic cleavage. Homolytic cleavage, in sense, it is a free radical formation. If it is an heterolytic cleavage, means it is formation of cations and anions. Always you have your Norrish type 1 of cleavage deals with a homolytic cleavage only. Just you keep remember that. Always this Norrish type 1 will result into homolytic cleavage. And where it happens? It happens to the carbonyl compounds only. So that these carbonyl compounds upon these photochemical reactions result into the free radical formation as a step 1. That is a primary process. And decarbonation is a secondary process, and combination or termination type of the reactions we are expected to get your combining these two radicals to get your terminated product. So the termination may takes place in two different way. One is your dimerization reactions or disproportionation type of the reaction. So finally, depending upon the starting material, you can have your alkane as a product or alkene as a product. So depending upon your any kind of the termination type of the reactions also. So this is the information that I am trying to point out in the case of our Norrish type 1 reaction. So we will see the in forthcoming our videos, we can be able to see the Norrish type 2 with some detailed examinations also, and with the examples we will point out. With the competitive examination type of questions also we are going to discuss in the Norrish type 2. Now my time to say that thank you for watching this video. Like it, share it and subscribe it for more number of videos in this chemistry platform. Thank you.